Ghosts in the gardens. We are walking in the gardens. The ghosts are there. And my son asks, "So what happened?" I said, "We just stopped. We ran out of ideas, out of energy. We gave in to the distraction and pleasure of things until we were lost and trapped and enslaved. While we looked away, life was lost. Only when finally we turned everything off did we see the ghosts in the garden, and that was too late." We sat on a bench made of stone with the ghosts in the garden, in silence, not needing to speak. But then my son asked, "Why doesn't anything work anymore?" And I said, "It never did. The things we valued were wrong. The things that helped make life easier stopped us living. Instead of being bored, we used people and places and things. And then we could not be bored anymore. And all we had were the things. And there was no space anymore. And there was no time anymore. Before the fall, in 2029, we saw too late that the things were the problem. And that's why they don't work anymore." We worked a little, side by side, with the ghosts in the garden, between the rows of stumps, organising the gravel path. When my son asked, "Why aren't there any oak trees anymore?" And I said, "There used to be many different trees, but then we cut them all down to get to the coal, to plant different trees, to make furniture, to see the view. And then the insects died, and we found that you cannot dry oak tree seeds. You just have to look after the trees." And in the end, my son asked, "Why are there ghosts in the garden?" I pulled the rake through the gravel and said, "Stones hold the memory of every living thing. Every living thing is an agreement between us and the earth. When something dies, when you kill something, what's left is a memory held in a stone. When the garden is empty, all you see are the memories. Shadows on a cave wall. A haunted garden. The light too bright from a dying sun. A haunted planet." He was me. And I was dead. And so was he.